Houston got better with their signings. They're making moves to go deep in the playoffs. Detroit signed Vildor, which is zero help to the Lions' already subpar secondary.
Well,
it's not like Vildor was the whole offseason, bud.
Yeah, but Carlton Davis, Amik Robertson, and you know, I know people want to take shots at the Lions, but yeah, the Houston Texans are making signings so that they can hopefully make a run deep into the playoffs. You know who did make a run deep into the playoffs? Detroit Lions.
Yep. And Brock Wright, a move that they made, John. We had talked about this. Would they match? Would they retain him? Would they lose him to the San Francisco 49ers? Your vote was, yeah, just pay him.
Yeah.
My vote was, yeah, let's match. And that's what they ended up doing.
It seems like it's a very low cost to keep a highly productive. Now, it's not going to be a lot of stats that you're looking at. 13 catches last year, 91 yards. All right, nobody's going to look at that and go, yeah, that's a million-dollar tight end. But when you look at what he provides this team, confidence in the run game, of being able to set the edge, being able to be at the point of attack, get some cutoffs backsides, like you want to be able to utilize Montgomery, Gibbs, and all that this offense has to provide. And to do that, you need somebody to do the dirty work. And Brock Wright is a guy that's going to do all the dirty work.
You play two tight end sets, you need two tight ends. I really thought some of this, too, was the fact that San Francisco wanted him. They have George Kittle, and they valued getting a blocking tight end, a second tight end, someone to free up the run game. It's everything Detroit wants to do. That's your head-to-head competition more than anybody else, right? I mean, the Cowboys, they were the two seed. And the Eagles, they played in the Super Bowl the year before. But the biggest competition in the NFC is San Francisco. And if they valued a guy that does all the little things that you like to do as well, you can't lose him. Not over $1 million.
No. And now it's going to be, what do we know about James Mitchell, Shane Zylstra for that position? Because if they had lost Brock Wright, didn't match it, then you'd be looking at those guys to pick up the slack. Now that they decided to pay Brock Wright, are they looking at James Mitchell and saying, yeah, I don't. Maybe that's a pick that's not working out for us.
One fewer need, right? We had the last guy calling and go, I still need a fourth string long snapper.
TE2. Well,
yeah. You don't need a second tight end at this point. Which, hey, it's small stuff, right? I mean, that's whenever we bring up this Brock Wright thing, I'm like, you know, how big a deal? It's the little stuff that they've built this team on. Campbell had highlighted Brock Wright going back last November. Like, this is one of those dudes that's part of who they are.
Well, it's all about the depth. And we were very concerned about what the tight end position would look like if Sam Laporta had to miss some time at the end of last year. Remember, he had the knee injury. He ended up not missing any time, but okay, if that was the case, Brock Wright was your guy.